request all done. Hour two on Route Foyer. This is Radio 2. We're on the BBC Sounds app on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 6 o'clock. This is Harvey Cook. The judge leading the inquiry into the infected blood scandal, which left thousands of NHS patients with HIV or hepatitis C, has recommended that survivors should be given initial compensation payments of £100,000 each. Almost 2,500 people infected in the 1970s and 80s have already died. Sir Brian Langstaff said the government was under no obligation to accept his findings, but he explained his thinking.
Sir Robert Francis QC recommended interim payments because the payment of full compensation could not be delivered quickly. He made a compelling case that interim payments are needed now to alleviate further suffering, and I agree with him.
Police in Lincolnshire have released the name of the 9-year-old girl who died after being stabbed in Boston. Lalilia Valutatir was found in the town centre yesterday evening. Two people have been arrested in connection with the killing, which police say was an isolated incident. Ukraine and Russia have accused each other of carrying out a rocket strike that's reported to have killed 40 Ukrainian prisoners of war. Kyiv says the site was targeted by Moscow to cover up evidence of killings and torture. The Kremlin said Ukraine carried out the strike with precision missiles. From Kyiv, here's Paul Adams.
The pictures are gruesome. A tangle of wrecked bunk beds in a smoking warehouse and bodies everywhere, many of them badly charred. This, Russia says, evidence of a Ukrainian rocket attack on a so-called filtration camp where Ukrainian prisoners of war were being held, many of them from Mariupol. But Ukraine says it carried out no military operations in the area. An advisor to President Zelensky has said the incident was a calculated mass murder by Russia. Dmytro Kuleba, Ukraine's foreign minister, has called it a war crime.
Rebecca Vardy has said she's devastated at losing her libel action against Colleen Rooney. Mrs. Rooney had accused her of leaking stories to the papers, which the judge ruled was true. Mrs. Rooney said the case should never have gone to court. The media barrister Mark Henderson says it demonstrates the dangers of taking legal action.
Bringing a libel case and losing it can do far more damage to your reputation than bringing it and winning it would have helped your reputation. And probably nothing proves that more than this case. It's probably a worst case scenario for Ms. Vardy.
The governing body of English Rugby Union, the RFU, has voted in favour of restricting transgender participation in the domestic game. Only players recorded as female at birth will be allowed to play in the women's category. At the Commonwealth Games, the paracyclist Neil Fackey has won gold for Scotland. He won the 1,000 metres time trial ahead of James Ball of Wales and Stephen Bates of England. And the weather, thick cloud and outbreaks of blustery rain will move into the northwest this evening, reaching much of the north by dawn. It'll be a mild night everywhere. And that's the BBC News at 3 minutes past six.
Harvey, thank you very much.
Sarah Cox, Sarah Cox, BBC Radio.
And just like that, we are off with hour two. Just remember, I didn't say thank you to Steve Wright and his serious jock in yonks ago. I know. Rude madam. Thanks, Steve. Let's kick off hour two with a tune suggested by Donna and the Smith family, Tyler and Amber included. They're all currently in Carmarthenshire at their wigwam on Rivendell Farm in the hot tub overlooking the valley with a glass of bubbles. They've been celebrating Wesley's 50th birthday with their own mini festival, Wesfest. Happy birthday, Wes. Here's your tune, mate.